Investigators are piecing together how New York City's unique geology was formed. Much of its early success as a trade and commerce center is owed to its deep water harbor and its location at the coast. But 450 million years ago, things were different. The area of New York City was landlocked, embedded in the heart of a huge supercontinent. How did it get to the coast? The investigation fast-forwards 250 million years. In a quarry in New Jersey, 25 miles northeast of Manhattan, paleontologist Paul Olson unearths the first of a string of clues that could explain how New York City reached the coast. A giant fossilized footprint.
This is the footprint, actually the mud that filled in the footprint, of a four-footed crocodile relative that was the dominant carnivore during the late Triassic. You can see the toes here have little pads on them, and here's the handprint. And these animals would have been, in this case, about the size of a modest crocodile, but some of them became much, much larger, the size even of a T-Rex.
The footprints are from a huge crocodile-like creature called Postosuchus. It first appeared on the Earth around 230 million years ago. Then, some 30 million years later, its footprints suddenly vanished. But Postosuchus wasn't alone. Half of all land animals perished at the same time. The fossil evidence proves it to be one of the biggest mass extinctions ever recorded.
The evidence for this mass extinction is that we have lots and lots of fossils right in this area. And what you see is, especially in the reptile footprints, you see one group of forms, the forms that are related to crocodilians, disappear.
Whatever caused the mass extinction must have been a catastrophic event. Olson had a hunch that the mass extinction was somehow related to New York's return to the coast. The ancient area of New York sat on a line of great weakness, the plate boundary where two continents joined to form the supercontinent Pangaea. And it was unstable, prone to earthquakes and volcanoes. Olson's quest to find the evidence for the natural disaster that finished off Postosuchus 200 million years ago. A band of dark rock above the footprints in the New Jersey quarry caught his eye. It was basalt, the smoking gun Olson was looking for. Basalt is a volcanic rock. It forms when hot lava erupts onto the surface and cools. Did the volcanoes that forged this basalt trigger the mass extinction and also rip Pangaea apart? On its own, the evidence at the quarry was unconvincing. The layer of basalt is only a few feet thick. To prove mass lava flows caused this global catastrophe, scientists needed corroborative evidence. High above the Hudson River, geologist Matt Goring follows another lead. He's studying the Palisades, a dramatic geologic feature that hugs the Hudson River, beginning across mid-Manhattan and running into northeast New Jersey. They, too, are made of basaltic rock, the same rock implicated in the mass extinction of land animals. But the Palisades are on an altogether different scale.
The Palisades are a sheet of basaltic magma about 1,000 feet thick. It's about 40 miles long, so it's a very prominent set of cliffs that run all the way up the west side of the Hudson River.
Here is proof of massive volcanic activity. Hot lava flooded out of ruptures in the Earth's crust and covered ancient North America in a mile-deep sheet. The lava cracked as it cooled. The vertical ruptures formed regular pencil-shaped columns. These distinctive rock formations have been known to geologists since the 19th century. Intriguingly, they appear on both sides of the Atlantic, in North and South America, Europe, and Africa. Geologists suspected that their presence pointed to the spot where Africa and Europe separated from America. But that was just an unproven theory. Until the 1950s, when scientists developed a revolutionary technique called paleomagnetism. Now, they could study the magnetic properties of rocks. Many rocks, including basalt, have a distinctive magnetic signature, formed as the rock is born. Tiny crystals inside the rock act like compass needles. When the magma that forms the rock is fluid, the crystals align to the Earth's magnetic field, pointing north. As the rock solidifies, the crystals freeze, forever locked in that fixed magnetic alignment. As continents move and the rocks travel, the crystals end up pointing in a different direction than north. Goring and his team investigate the magnetic signature of the Palisades. To get a sample, they bore into the rock with a water-cooled drill. They measure the exact orientation of the crystals today with a compass. When they offset this reading with magnetic north, they can calculate the original location of the rock.
14. One of the useful things that you can do with this rock is you can take it back in the lab and measure its magnetic orientation. And that magnetic orientation will be when this rock crystallized or solidified 200 million years ago. So this rock would have minerals that would be pointing in some other direction other than north today.
When scientists compared the magnetic orientation of the Palisades with the other basalt outcrops around the Atlantic, they discovered they formed at approximately the same latitude. Not only did the rocks have the same age, they were also born at the same location. For example, 200 million years ago, New York and Morocco were neighbors. The geologists had all the proof they needed. They could now confidently piece together what happened. It began with a global volcanic disaster.
About 200 million years ago, North America and Africa began to pull apart from each other. There were gigantic lava outpourings. These lava flows erupted along very long cracks in the Earth's crust that would have produced fountains of lava extending thousands and thousands of feet into the atmosphere. They covered an almost inconceivably large area, roughly 4 million square miles, from southwestern France to southwestern Brazil, from New York to central Mali in Africa. This area was covered in ponded lava flows that in some places ended up being nearly a mile thick.
Volcanic eruptions led to soaring temperatures. Half of the plants and animals died. Postosuchus didn't stand a chance. As enormous forces tore Pangaea apart, a giant sea formed between the separating land masses, the Atlantic Ocean. The city of New York was now at the coast.